Hi, I'm Aaron Gold for Auto Vitale, and today we are driving the Chevrolet Cruze Eco, which is the extra special, super fuel efficient version of the Cruze sedan. In fact, the Cruze Eco is the most fuel efficient, non-hybrid, non-diesel car you can buy. At least it used to be the most fuel efficient, non-hybrid, non-diesel car you could buy until the 2014 Mitsubishi Mirage came along. Stupid Mitsubishi. Anyway, so what makes the Eco an Eco? Well, primarily, they've made a lot of aerodynamic changes. They've covered over the fog lights, they've fitted shutters to the grille, so when the car doesn't need cooling air, it closes off the grille and you get better airflow around the car. And they fitted lightweight 17-inch wheels. Now, the manual transmission car gets a little extra love. It has a specially geared 6-speed manual transmission, and they even cut the fuel tank capacity by 3 gallons to save weight. Under the hood is the same 1.4-liter engine that is found in other Cruze models. This has a turbocharger and it puts out 138 horsepower and a nice flat torque curve. No real changes to the engine for the Eco model. Most of the changes are in the transmission. The trunk is probably one of the Cruze's best features. 15 cubic feet, which is enormous by compact car standards. Now you notice this big open area here. Most Cruzes have a panel that goes here to give you a flat floor, but they've taken that away in the Cruze to save weight. They've also eliminated the spare tire and given you an inflator kit, which saves about 26 pounds. Every little ounce counts, right? The Cruze's back seat is certainly not the roomiest car in its class, but nor is it the most cramped. There's enough room back here for adults, even normal-sized adults who are taller than I am. We've been using this car as our family car, and I do wish it had like fake leather or something that wore a little bit better than this cloth. But it is comfortable, and the family does fit. Now, the interior of this car is not bad. It's not one of General Motors' newest designs. The Cruze came out in 2011, and it was introduced in Europe a few years before that. But it's got halfway decent materials, nice cloth on the seats, fairly simple control layout, and it has the OnStar system. This is a subscription-based service that will give you voice command of your Bluetooth phone. It'll allow you to get turn-by-turn directions, even without a full-on navigation system. It displays them on the dash. And most importantly, if you get into a crash, OnStar will be notified, and they'll call you to see if you need help. And if you do need help, or if you can't answer, the OnStar people can pinpoint the location of the car and send emergency services to you. It's well worth the cost of the subscription. Now, the Cruze Eco combines this turbocharged engine with a 6-speed manual transmission with 3 overdriven gears. Most 6-speeds, 5th and 6th gears are overdrive. In this one, 4th, 5th, and 6th are all overdriven. Basically, that lets you turn the turbo on and off at will. So if you need acceleration, you downshift a second, you give it the beans, and you have the power that you would get in a 2-liter engine. Then when you reach your cruising speed, shift up into a higher gear, the engine revs drop, the turbo goes dormant, and you get really outstanding fuel economy. How outstanding? Well, the EPA estimates for the Cruze Eco manual are 28 miles per gallon city and 42 miles per gallon on the highway. Now, unfortunately, the automatic does not have the special gearing, and it doesn't do quite as well. It's rated at 26 city and 39 on the highway, which is still pretty good, but if you want the absolute best fuel economy, you have to go for the manual transmission. Now, a lot of people hear manual transmission and they go, oh, I don't want a manual. I live in this city, blah, 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 blah. And I understand. I live in Los Angeles. But you know, this is a really nice manual. It's got a very light clutch pedal. It's got a really precise shifter. Not a bad car to get stuck in traffic. There is quite a bit of shifting. One of the consequences of that super tall gearing is that when you hit a steep hill on the freeway, you often have to downshift to 4th, sometimes even to 3rd gear to get the turbo going and make it up the hill. I don't mind that, but I don't know. If you got a weak right arm, I guess it's something to think about. Now, pricing for the Cruze Eco starts at $20,760. That's about $1,120 more than a comparably equipped Cruze without the Eco package, but it's thousands of dollars less than a hybrid or a diesel. And this car really delivers on what it promises. My wife and I have been driving this particular Cruze Eco for 6 months. We put nearly 15,000 miles on the car. We're averaging over 37 miles per gallon, and we've repeatedly seen low to mid 40s on our road trips, and that's on cheap 87-octane fuel. Those numbers aren't as good as a hybrid or a diesel, but the car costs so much less, and at the end of the day, you wind up saving money. The better part of it is this is an American car. It's actually built in Ohio, not Mexico or Canada, like a lot of American cars, and we have had no problems whatsoever. 15,000 miles, not a single trip to the dealership except for oil changes. This is a reliable car. It's a fuel-efficient car. It's reasonably sized. It's a great choice if you want to save fuel without the upfront investment in a hybrid or a diesel. Thanks for watching. I'm Aaron Gold for Auto Vitale, and I'll see you next time.